Poopsies, it's me, Tony Bomboni. Welcome back to your ASMR session. Oh, I totally even forgot I was wearing this. Just a fun little thing. And my donut shirt. Today's video is about hurt, pain, more hurt, like when someone feels sad or frustrated about something. Usually anger, frustration, is kind of like suppressed pain, so it, meaning hurt, meaning people are not aware that it all tends to kind of lead down to that, so I wanted to make a chill video about that today. It's linked in with something I've been going through a lot lately with sort of many people, and how to heal old wounds in that regard. So I find it very important to me to talk about it and kind of get through it in a spiritual manner with other people. Two candles next to me, a Himalayan salt lamp, and these lights, and my ring light, and it's a bajillion degrees in here, so if I start to sweat, that's why. And I just wanted to do something to get your mind off anything that you may be going through, and somehow some of the ways to deal and cope with things in a healthier manner, you know. This video is not guaranteed to help in any way with anything you're going through, however, anything to take your mind off it, such as the ASMR, is special in itself, so. Of wear things. I like the sound this makes when it rubs against it. Oh gosh, these candles are really warm. Like a really big heat generator here in this corner. But yeah, warm things like this, kind of orangey, reddish colors, yellowy colors like this, kind of, I like getting into the vibe. Being in a room, decorating it in that kind of environment, and staying in that place when I feel cold and insecure within myself. And so I felt like these colors were very important to me. Fun things like this, silly things like this, you know, decorative things to get my mind off whatever I'm going through. And I always keep this third eye necklace. I've had it since 2013-14, that cusp, and I saw it in this one spiritual psychic tarot reader videos. Her name was One Spiritual Witch, and she doesn't post anymore. It was, I believe, for many reasons, but I loved her video so much, and I saw this necklace she was wearing. Don't wear it, but like I kind of miss wearing things like this, kind of out there kind of stuff, and feeling like I belong more in that category, that realm of things, so I'm surprised I haven't bothered. I don't usually wear jewelry, but this is adjustable. I just have to kind of pull it out. I don't know why it's not, but just, you know, do different. Keep it over the salt lamp because it looks cool, and it kind of reminds me to see things through another perspective. That's what I associate the eye as, and a kind of ever-knowing presence. And you can always channel that presence within you through your higher self. And so the salt lamp itself makes me feel comforting, good for the lungs, breathing. The air, and kind of just ionizes the room through the power of the salt and the heat, and Usually I report feeling better after lighting the sun for an hour or two, being around it. Kind of before bedtime, it sets the dimness mood in the room so that you can prepare yourself for sleep. Usually people have bright lights in the room and then they turn them off and they can't sleep because they were around bright lights. Sometimes you have to kind of adjust to fall asleep, and it usually takes me a good 2-3 hours to get rest, mostly because I'm on my phone. So that's that. And lighting candles helps again with that serene mood lighting, nice pleasant environment, and it makes me calm. I associate a candle with calm. Ever since I was young, whenever I light a candle, I do. I just am instantly calm. I like doing it for you, the tarot reading for you guys, which I have on my website. I do tarot readings and Reiki healings, and I light a candle every time when I do them because it just gets me in the mode of calm. So when I'm calm, I can channel energies more, focus better. Also use this in my Reiki. There is love and energy in anything, and I associate this with love, especially with the oil, rose petal, excuse me. I love having rose petals around the house, dried up ones and fresh newly ones, and I believe we have one growing in the front of the house too, so it's real pretty, but they dry. Like having love in my life, I like attracting that in my life, and so sometimes I'll sprinkle some in like a bath or have like a bath bomb with those kind of dried up petals. So I like the aroma. I believe when you kind of focus your mind on something good rather than the hurt and pain and suffering of this world, like to have this is perfect on your skin. You can smell it, and when you perspire, at least you can use your imagination to the best of your capability. Instead of the typical lotion and pressing it from the top or just self-care like I'm doing now is vital for your mental health, and I think all of that will be nice. Like I've mentioned before, our subconscious mind likes to get to pleasure as fast as possible, so we do things to please ourselves when we feel this suffering. It's okay if it goes over the crystals. Give the crystals some love as well. Affection. Everything is alive. Don't forget. You guys wanted some hand stuff as well. I believe in the power of people's hands and that we can heal each other all with our hands. So just imagine just a glowing aura. Nice protective mechanism. A nice gentle reminder of what is, and a guidance, a saving grace, a prayer, whatever that may resemble. This time in your life, compassion, kindness, anything you need now comes through the hands to you. It is all there, ready to be accessed. And it is accessible anytime you choose and everywhere. Visualize the aromas bouncing through you in the heat wave of this energy. It's all there for you now. It is all there for you now. And you know it. And you sense and feel it everywhere. It is there. It is there. It is a gentle reminder. It is your hopes and dreams. It is your fulfillment and fantasy. It is there. Ready when you are. The gift of life. The presence of love. The aroma of excitement and the blissful attitude of nature. This as part of our journey today. find little things that you can mix and match in ASMR world, and blend a set of triggers that will kind of soothe your sensations. I'm gonna mix some of my oil on this now. Let's just make everything nice and oily and fragrant. Why not? You can always wash it off later. I haven't been using this. Usually any spiritual tools I use are pretty short-lived. I've always kind of been switching and trying different things, and I don't use things for too long. I'm always trying to find the next new thing that I can use, and I'll just use it and use it until I get sick and tired. This is a plaque, or plaque, whatever you want to call it, wall hanging, if you want to be boring about it. And it was given to me for Christmas very, very, very long ago. It's probably a decade now. And it's this belief. It's it in Japanese, I believe. I believe. And it was a nice reminder to believe in myself. Gotten me through sometimes. To just have this as a reminder on my wall, it was like just to wake up and look at it every morning. It was really nice when I needed it, and the colors are all nice and blend together. I've definitely shown this before, but we're gonna roll this towards you now. We're gonna roll the intent, all the good moments I've had from this toward you. I'm just gonna sweep it to you like a sand garden. Doesn't have to make sense. You just focus on moving your eyes up and down, side to side. That's right. There you go. Mindless activity like this really does get our mind off things. It is so effective to get rid of any anxieties and fears, because you're so focused on one thing that the rest falls away. The irrelevance. Shh, 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 shh. didn't need to worry, and you didn't need to stress or fret. Not that it was pointless, but on a term where you can come into agreement with it and move on from it would be nice. Of you and your health rather than these intrusive thoughts. You knew this all along. This was just a nice moment to remind you of that. Your nice little therapy session. I'm glad to be here with you today to know that everything will be okay. Ultimately, everything will be okay and fall into place and play. You can have fun with anything you do. It's all you're feeling life get in the way, it feels like it's getting out of hand, none of this may be helping you, and again, that's okay. I always advise writing things down. getting a sense of anger and frustration. Sadness, fear, anxiety, depressed, alone, scared, this is the same. Resentful. One final thing I wanted to do is pull out some cards for you and see what's going on. Like the traditional spiritual video. So, I'm gonna start off with this deck. I was actually intuitively drawn to just this deck, and this one I usually do. Oh, and I have one more treat for you at the very end, but I'll keep it a surprise. And, hopes and dreams finally being manifested. You're taking a moment now, as in through this video, to reflect on and sort of divulge in what you want now. And you've kind of just stripped yourself literally naked of some of your resources. You still feel there could be even a sense of hopelessness, anger, frustration. I'm getting all of those things coming in, but you're tired, you're drained energetically, you're taking the time to figure things out now and how you can move forward with your life and progress now, and you're sort of just a lack of resource now, but you're taking things into consideration, all that you can. Coming together. It's giving you the final message and clarification of what Ten of Cups, ultimately, it's all about love and compassion. Someone has hurt you. It is very clear in this case. And so, you want to rejoice and rebound with this individual. You would like to recuperate, share memories, get together again, experience life, renew them. But also, through a different person this time, you want to reach out and experience that through this individual, this new person coming in. And they're reminding you of old ways, and in a good way, old ways, not negative patterns, but more cherishing moments. You get to see each other, and when you're away from them, it's almost like the pain and hurt comes back, and you're alone again, and you're wanting this again, and it's like you crave that intimacy again, you crave that satisfaction of knowing someone's there for you at any time you desire, and they are there for you. They mean a lot to you. They are like the diamond, like a hard diamond in your life, like a solid kind of, I'm seeing it's like a crystallized watery substance of some sort. Like, they are solid right now. And you're just dancing and enjoying time together. And that's your kind of uplifting vibe there. And the Devil, again, the hurt can still come back even through some of these moments, but even with this person, just keep in mind the shared bond and memories together, and the unification and bonding of your energies, the wholeness and oneness and peace, and also a sense of reality it gives you. You're kind of real and raw with them. It's mutual bond, share, trust, respect, and they kind of make you feel almost guilty sometimes, because you feel afraid to let out those emotions or be sexual with them or come out, come to the surface. But then they make you feel like secure enough to do so. In a way, you feel comfortable and safe enough to be yourself and express yourself through them. And it's like this pulsing eye now, like you're beginning to see the bigger picture of how things go. Showing your masculinity, but also your submissiveness on the same side. It's really a blend of forces here. And so it's something new to you. It's not unfamiliar, but it's like grounding territory for you. It's very grounding, earthly healing. And also, I am seeing the watery again, though. You guys could be both mixing water signs. But it's like you're willing to give your all now, pour out your emotions to this person as well. Fun together, and not just close yourself off again. You feel like you're alive around them, and it's coming to reality now and shifting your perspective. So this is beautiful. I almost left this video, and I completely forgot about this last thing. This is my favorite crystal so far, and again, you've seen it before, just not in its proper aura. When the light is shining against it, like this part is sort of lime green, and then it goes to like aqua blue, then dark purple and light purple. It sort of looks like what you'd imagine like the underwater seas of Titan would potentially be, and the cracks in it, and the overall obelisk monumental shape is to die for. So I just thought I'd hold it, give out the best energy I could through me, through this crystal, to you, through the screen, and end this video off in that regard. So just enjoy for whatever it is. If you've watched my Vex About Crystals video, you know that I say that how you feel even holding this up against the screen. Most of you did report feeling something, however, some of you didn't. So just kind of, it's like a placebo effect, you know, because we are through a distance, and that's how I do some of my Reiki healing with the crystals. And it sort of just projects through you. Most of it is the work of your own mind, though. And so that's the empowering aspect of it. So would like to believe that there is something behind it, so just acknowledge it for what it is and accept it into your moment, whatever it may be. Associate this with anything that you desire, and so it will be to you, and you can appreciate that for what it is, even if you think it's just a rock. So let's just pretend to hold it together, you hands touching mine, and just observing this for what it is. You can close your eyes and meditate with me a bit. It's just going to be a little meditation, and just with a couple deep breaths, and you may feel something. You may feel the warmth, the heat of my hands, the energy. You can feel free to put your hands against your laptop or something. Just imagine we're holding this together and enjoying this moment for whatever it is, whatever your imagination takes you. That's it. Okay. Right. And I hope this video has helped you in many ways possible, and I will see you in the next one. Oopsies, be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell.